Now we can get a better look at it, especially since I shut that big dude off. That in place, all I gotta do is slide it in there. I've already checked my dimension and I have 1/8 of an inch total, so that gives me 1/16 of an inch for each one of my gaskets, and that's exactly what they are. So now I just put that in, and then I'll button these two ends up, and then I'll button that up, and then I'll take my locks off, turn the pump on, turn the valves on, not necessarily that order, close enough, and then we will check for gasket leaks. We can check them for weld leaks because we know that ain't gonna leak. Nice job, I do say so myself. Alright, I got 4 bolts in the bottom. Leaves me 4 open at the top, so now all I gotta do is swing my gaskets in. Start smoothing them down. I will say this is in upside down on for a reason. It's done purposely. It's upon their request for easier access, even because it flows regardless, it catches to the screen. Now this is the one that the contractor did, which in my opinion is pretty shoddy welds, and they charged them out the yin yang nearly $5,000 just to do that. So yeah, I think up that. And it got me a TIG machine, so. Okay, so now it's all buttoned up. And all I gotta do is go pull my locks and pressure it up. How about you, Conway?
Yeah.
I'm ready to turn this hexo on and give it a pressure up check.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, I think we're good. Okay, so now it's all buttoned up, and all I gotta do is go pull my locks and pressure it up.